So welcome to my session about migrating from FortiWrite Old to FortiWrite Pro. I think you all are working with FortiWrite Old. Instead, you would not be sitting here, right? Okay. Let me say, I will try to show you the best way how to migrate. Come back to this later. If you want to see me in real shape, my name is still Achim as yesterday, and I'm still working for FortiGermany as yesterday. Let's see. today we do not want to talk about real new features of FortiWrite Pro. Real new features have been presented in the morning in the next room. Room next door, or let me say, nearly not. For this, we had this session. For this, there was the session from Julien. I don't know who joined the other session from FortiWrite Pro before the lunch. Someone of you? Okay, four guys, fine. Excuse me. I want to make you familiar with the internals and the ideas or the new ideas behind FortiWrite Pro, with the way how things work, that you maybe already did in the old FortiWrite. But in the old FortiWrite, it was a bit different. I will show you how you do the same thing, or maybe better things, with the new FortiWrite Pro. So, in other words, as the title was in the beginning, migration. How to migrate your old FortiWrite way of working, or your old programming from FortiWrite Old to the new FortiWrite Pro. Only if you know the new concepts of FortiWrite Pro, you will be able to migrate the good way, the best way, the right way. I think you know what I mean. The list is long. And honestly, we cannot talk about all in this list. We will focus on the important things. But it is important for me that you get all material from my complete migration training, and my migration training is still growing. It's not finished now. The content still grows. There's still more content. On your USB key, you have the complete demos, so the complete session material, the complete scripts, how to play with the demos to see the right effects. To do it in self-study at home or in the plane tomorrow or where else, so that you have the material at home and can work with it and not forget what you have seen or not seen. Before starting our demo, a bit basics. While the old 4D, right, was a plugin, or let me say an external program, and there was not such a direct bind with 4D itself, a certain bind, but not a direct bind. The bind that every plugin has with 4D. The FortiWrite Pro is a native 4D object, or a native 4D form object, a native component inside 4D, and is totally embedded in 4D. So you have the full control, you can use all of the power of 4D, we will see in a moment. The full control, the full communication, and this in a very easy way. If you use it in a variable on the form to display your users when he writes letters or documents, you have to declare it using C object. Why? Yeah, because it's an object, a 4D object inside, like the objects you have seen this morning or yesterday morning in the keynotes. After the type declaration, you have to define it as not only as the type declaration is only to say this is the 4D object type, data type, variable type. Then you have to define it as a FortiWrite Pro document. Additionally, imagine you say C long integer my sum. That's C long integer, but not more. The next thing is to say my sum gets to 5. Then it has the value 5. You can understand it the same way. And with WP new and a choice of different parameters, you can choose what you want to define if it is initially opened. You can use no parameter, then it is an empty document. Empty variables are not a kind of null as starting value. And we will see it during the session that you can use different sources. We will see it in a moment. Because the FortiWrite Pro is an object type, you can also use the 4D command new object. It's an object. You must not use WP new. You can use new object to do the same. Very easy. We come back later on using which commands we can use with the FortiWrite Pro. As you know it from the old FortiWrite, you can do a direct bind to your structure field. In case of old FortiWrite, a blob. In case of new FortiWrite, an object field. Old FortiWrite, blob. Or has someone pictures for his old FortiWrite documents yet? Yes or no?
Yes.
Yes, okay, change it immediately. No, you have to rework, but we come back to this later. I don't want to lose my red line, this red line. The same way you can bind your FortiWrite Pro area, but a bit easier than before. You know, in FortiWrite old, this was name of the document plus underscore for the field and name of the document without underscore for the area and the form. And in this case, we have the same. It's easier. You must not think about, do I need an underscore or not? Oh, it does not work. I have to check with underscore or without underscore. It's easier now. So, this was theory and basics, and there were other sessions for basics in FortiWrite Pro. We will step inside that you can see the way of working. V17, I have V17. I have the 32-bit version of 17. Why? Not because FortiWrite Pro is not 64-bit aware or such things, because I want to show both in parallel. And therefore, 32-bit, because the old FortiWrite only works for 32-bit, therefore the 32-bit version. We want to get some content into our empty FortiWrite area on top. And I do it by loading a document from disk, in this case. It is a document, a .htm document, but be careful, it is a 4D-HTML document. A 4D-HTML document, because 4D has certain, how shall I name it? You are never sure if your HTM document is well-formed. You can never be sure. FortiWrite Pro is waiting for a well-formed document. And some other things with special references and so on. I don't want to tell too much about this now. And then you can read it and you can be sure that all what is inside is well displayed without any errors or so. WP new, instead of empty, we load the document as HTML text in a text variable and give this text to the FortiWrite Pro area for the initial opening. That was very easy, and this could be the nice document. A picture placed on the page, some text in columns, background picture, and so on. And down at the end of the text, you see some references to the current time and the current date. So nothing special. Not all from the old FortiWrite, but it's It's nothing so special. Let us have a look at possibilities for debugging. How before have you debugged your old FortiWrite Pro, especially if you build up your documents step by step in an off-screen area? How did you do it? Exactly. Others? There was a simple way, but an, let me say, ancient way. Open external window. FortiWrite. But it was a bit different, because now you had rendering. And things could behave differently than without rendering. And the window type you used with open external windows was an old way of working, and you should never do this anymore. Excuse me. And what can we do? Here you see the content of your FortiWrite Pro area. Easy readable, or? It's an automatism. You know, all what you have in an object can be, in case of the debugger, it is all automatically stringified by 4D. And there you see the content. And if you have a big, or also in this case, do you understand what you see? No. Say no. If you would have said no, I would have answered to you, oh, you can open this. And then you see all the attributes inside the object. As, for example, author, document information, background information, border information, column information, when it was created, margin information, padding information, and all what is inside. Yes? I have never checked it. No, I'm not sure. I'm not sure.
Probably yes, because there should be much more, you know, and the scroll bar is already in the end, so there is some limitation of the number.
No. This is all what is in the document container, visible in the in the object container. There is a different thing. And now we come to the difference. You might, if you want, change the values here. And if you tap out of the line, the modification is adjusted to your content. But here you cannot see the content of the real document content, your text or your pictures. This is not visible here. This is stored in an internal format. And what can you do with this? Okay, this is a lot more than was possible before, because this was never possible before. We can call ST, I always miss, ST get plain text command from the multicell text chapter in the manual. And then you see the raw text without any formatting. There is evidence of human habitation in Thailand. Raw text. Or if you use the command st-get text, you get back the formatted text. So in other words, the text with the span text for formatting. No pictures. But you can see content. That's not enough. You want to see more. Okay. We can use a kind of external window. And we will do it here. WP export variable. And with this command, I export the complete FortiWrite Pro content as 4D HTML into a text variable. And you see here a nice constant as WK HTML debug. And then, if we go ahead, it could like this way. And this is the complete content in a form that you, if you might, you need it, can read the content as, for example, made it a bit bigger. Here we have the title, the metadata of the document, style sheets, if there should exist some style sheets, then the body starts, with padding information, background information. Here we have our first image as automatically converted from 4D Write Pro into Base 64. And this, we can scroll down to the end. Picture, 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 two pictures inside, you have seen it. And here we have again some information, the references you see, and this is a special 4D thing, I meant a 4D ref. It's no overall valid HTML construct. Yes, it's 4D reference, or a string of current date, then string of current time, and so on. And if you want to see this, if you are familiar with this, have a look at it. It's nice, yeah? Do if you want. And also here you can modify. I want to modify the padding from 28 to 128. And if I press tab, nothing would happen. I have to do the same as we did when opening the 4D Write Pro era initially, WP new. And the modified text in the text variable as input for WP new, and we see the result in a moment. The padding has changed. So if you might need such working for debugging reasons, you can do it and check immediately. It's much more easier than to open context windows and choose the right entry for modifying the padding or the background color or what else, or trying with programming commands. This is a very easy way to, yes, to debug. And if you see what I checked here is okay, then do the programming for the same. Okay, I talk and talk and talk and forgot where I am. Okay, a next way of bringing content into your 4D Write Pro era, because comes later. So what on the left, you see it in the title, it is a multi-style text field stored in the database. Multi-style text, you all know multi-style text, I think we implemented multi-style with V13 or so, I'm not completely sure, but there's a text, and if we switch to the references by using the multi-style text commands, I will not do a training for multi-style text commands, but then you see the references we have on top. Vcontent is a variable reference. Return underscore address is my method returning the complete address of the customer, and a link, and so on and so on. Yeah, 4D commands, and you know, it's not new. It's these are the possible references you can insert into multi-style text fields. It all is surrounded by some text, and we can call WPNew also with a parameter. Parameter in this case is our multi-style text field stored in the text field in the structure. A next possibility, and that's it. All the references are living. And if you want to see values, you click on Show Values to use, or again to show references, to use the multi-style text commands with 4D Write Pro. Okay, and go back. Fine. Now, as a next step, I think you do not want to fill content for all your Write Pro elements only by getting old things or only by writing it manually. So let's have a look on the next page. Which 4D commands can be used with 4D Write Pro? Because maybe you had a look already in the manuals, there are only some commands for 4D Write Pro, some special WP commands. Not as much as you know from the old 4D Write. How can we do all what we want to do or what we did before with such a small number of commands? Very easy, use all commands, not all, but use all commands we give you in 4D, commands with which you are familiar. And you know how they work. But please only use these that make sense to be used But where, how do you know which commands will make sense? The manual will say you, will tell you. Or if we stay one day here, I can tell you, but it's boring, believe me. So we do it with multi-style text commands as an example. All, in this case, all multi-style text commands will work with FortiWrite Pro. All. And what do we do here? I filled some nasty text, hello, some breaks, this is some text. This is my style text, yeah? WP new with the HTML source, and I have a great text. Next, line 6 to 9. We format the text we have inserted by, yeah, multi-style text commands. Or style text commands is the normal name. And we set from the beginning to the end of the text we have included, the font name, the size, style, and so on. Next, I use the string manipulation commands or the string commands in combination with st-get plain text to search for a certain word in my FortiWrite Pro text. And if I found the word sum, I will give him a special formatting. And if you have a look, attribute text color, I think all of you know 8000 is green, yeah? No? I also not. Okay, if we color the word sum in a special way, we insert the different expressions. ST insert expression. And all of you that are working with style text know this command. And I don't want to speak in detail about this, but we can insert the method, the 4D method, the project method, 4D commands, variables, and so on. All you could insert before, you can insert also here. And the last thing, I use the command highlight text from the entry control chapter in the manual, and then it looks the same as before. And of course, all with the usable references, or again, values, and you know from the old FortiWrite, if you save your document finally, you freeze the references so that the references stay in this with these values they had when saving, when freezing. And the same command also works here. And then we have no more references, all is freezed. Which other commands will work? Not all commands, but all commands. At the beginning of the object get set, so the, let me say, form object commands is a list which object get set commands will work with FortiWrite Pro. And I have a small choice of these, object set sizing. The next kind of 4D commands from a complete different area work with FortiWrite Pro. They all are adjusted, have been adjusted by us to work with FortiWrite Pro. To give you these commands you are familiar with to work with FortiWrite Pro in the future. And also the getter is always a question of getters and setters in 4D. I think you know 4D since years, you know maybe the problem. And the getter gives me how it is aligned now. Or you see it, it is right aligned. What else? All the spell checking commands work with FortiWrite Pro. So there is no special FortiWrite Pro spell checking. Use the commands to initialize your spell checking, depending on the language you want, and then call the command spell checking, and you get the spell checker. And he says, oh my God, that's the address from 4D Germany in Munich, in Obere Hauptstraße, upper Main Street, yeah? And the English language check does not know, upper or obere, and I will not correct it. You have seen that it worked. And what with your old FortiWrite programming, your old FortiWrite programming? Nothing. Why? Because it's no more suitable. It's carbon, it's 32-bit, it will not work anymore in the future, of course with 64-bit and not with FortiWrite Pro. But what with your old programming. One example. I think you know wrfind, to find all occurrences of any word in your text. These are the 4D commands for doing the same. I think you will understand what is on the screen. I must not explain to you. It is very easy, but WR does not work anymore. You have to do a different way. Maybe an easier way than before. Maybe more possibilities than before. So, and before, someone will ask you, where's the wrapper you have written for me? No, we haven't written any wrapper. It does not make sense. We checked it because WR old is not WP new. There will be different ways to come to the same or a better result that you before did with WR programming. So we don't want to waste resources for doing wrappers for this, wrappers in a kind that does not work the way you want. So do it if you need it by yourself. Okay, and what happens? The word sum is selected. And it's only one time inside, so it's only selected one time. And all the form events are working. And direct control, direct communication. Next thing, off-screen areas. Who of you has worked with off-screen areas in the old 4D, right? Yes, half of the guys, okay. You did it before WR, off-screen area, to get a new off-screen area. This off-screen area only existed in memory. No display, no time wasted for rendering or display. These areas were very important and often used, for example, to build letters fully automatically, maybe with an address inside, maybe then displayed on screen and the user could adjust some things, or maybe not, and then it could directly be printed fully automatically for 10,000 invoices a day. If we would write 10,000 invoices, if we all write 10,000 invoices, each of us, we would be happy, I think. Another thing, email, creating emails, in this case, HTML emails. It's really not new. We included this with the command SMTP quicksend in the version 14R5, so years ago, years ago. You can create your HTML emails and send it fully automatically by inserting the email address of the current record from the customer, and that's it. Very easy. Displayed it for some years, showed it for some years on the shows here. But okay, customers called in support and asked, oh, I need the off-screen areas urgently. Where are the off-screen areas? I will not find them. So they are present, but maybe not so obvious. 4DWrite Pro is and saves its content in a 4D object. So, the 4D object is your off-screen area. And let's check. So, what this method does here, we have seen in the very first demo, on the very first tab. We load the document from disk and display it on screen. And what do we do here? We load the document from disk, the same way into an HTML variable, then I have an additional off-screen object variable defined, HP new with the HTML text as before into the off-screen area, and that's it. And you can see my comment, do something here, do what you want. To modify this, we see it later in a different sample, and then OB copy. With OB copy, you copy objects from one object into the other object. And now I copy the object content from a main memory object into a displayed and rendered object. That's it. And you can see that the result is as it was before. So let's clear this. Let me see. I think I don't want it to clear. Here's my clear button. I have cleared it. WP new without parameter to clear. Or the second command was write new object. And now I want to do a bit more. I want to work with the object, with the off-screen area. Let's start the same way as before. I open the document, load it into the HTML variable. Next, WP new to bring the content into the off-screen area without rendering. Next, I get, it's only a nasty example, I get with st-get plain text all of the raw text from the document. So I get rid of the pictures and eventually tables because I ask for text in this sample. And if I have the text over there, I delete the area and override the empty content with the raw text in the off-screen area. Let me scroll down a bit. So, and here is a very important command. Create range. In the old 4DWrite, this concept was never existing. In the old 4DWrite, you had a selection from, let me say, character 5 to 10, or 1 to 100, or what else. You had a selection. And this selection could be formatted. Yes, the same way of working is true for the style text commands. But if you want to work with the WPro commands, you have to work a different way. From this selection, you have to, or from the complete content, you have to get a range, or to define a range. And this range is a sub-object of the complete document. And all the WPro commands, WP commands, to format your 4DWrite Pro content, all or a part, are working on these ranges. So you can, in the easiest case, imagine this as a kind of selection, but not only from N to M or M to N, but with all that is contained, all objects, all attributes, and all formatting, and all what else. And I do this here. Therefore, I needed the range. And this range I take to set different attributes, here only for the part from start of text till character 400. I have some more characters inside. And the rest is not affected. The rest of the text is not affected by this formatting. And then I show you that I take the complete off-screen area to set a background color for the complete area. And if this is done, I print it. WP print. And lastly, I copy it as before in the on-screen area to check what has happened. Maybe if the user shall do some modifications. And there we have the printout. Normally, I would use a printer and send it automatically to the printer. And you see, the background is in the complete document. The upper part is a big green font. The lower part is a standard font. Very easy example. And if we close this, we see exactly the same here. Not exactly, because the page width is a bit bigger than the paper format in the printout. But that's the way of working. So, and if you have heard today, I'm not sure, I forgot it yesterday, maybe also about the object notation. And you could ask me, what about the easy understandable, easy writable, easy readable, and so on and so on, usable, easy usable object notation? Yes, we can do. Because 4DWrite Pro is an object. Why not use object notation? And for this, I copy, because I want to show you how to use the object notation in the off-screen area. I also could do it in the on-screen area, but I want to make you familiar with working with off-screen areas. And so I copied the whole thing back. And then you can here use $offscreen.author, my attribute font family, the dot notation, the object, sorry, object notation. And author is an existing attribute, if you remember what we have seen in the debugger, so I can write values inside it. My attribute is not existing, but maybe if you know from objects, if you set an attribute with obset that not exists, it will be set by 4D for you. So I can adjust my own attributes here. And so I can, for example, say, oh, I have printed it, send it by mail. As my own document status, yeah? And font family, different font. Pay attention. All these things are case sensitive, they told you. 10 minutes? Okay. When did you start? For normal start or for the delayed start? Okay. And if you want, so I keep this short. This is a different kind of object syntax. And in this kind of syntax, you can use all of the constants of FortiWrite Pro. And the big point is if you work this way, you can use in the square brackets variables. And in this case, you can fill in a loop anything what you want to do great things, great generic things. And then it, okay. We see the modification in the formatting here. So, 10 minutes left. A very important point is converting of your old FortiWrite documents. And I load an old FortiWrite document, and therefore it's the 32-bit version, and you see some text in the header, some text with references here, and a nice picture in the text flow, and a picture in the header box. And we want to convert this WP new. And again, a command, a parameter, the content of an object field from the old FortiWrite, not object, blob, excuse me. And it looks the same. All references are there. You see text in header, text in the footer. The references are there. The picture is there. And if we would enlarge the picture, you see on this side in 1879, nothing has happened. But okay. That's conversion. We tried to do the converting job as good as possible, and we gathered from you, maybe not from you personally, but from you as developers, as 4D developers, lots of complex, big or what else documents to be prepared to check the conversion. If you try to convert your old documents and you will have problems, send these documents to us with freeze references as external documents, and we check what we can do for you. Not only for you, also for making our conversion better. This is for self-study. Bookmarks, bookmarks, new concept. They talked about in the session in the morning, that Julian talked about bookmarks there. Only so far, this is a bookmark text. You see no bookmarks? Yes, you see no bookmarks because bookmarks are not visible. Bookmarks, if we debug the content, bookmarks are a range. Here you see it in the metadata, the bookmark. For example, the bookmark introduction goes from character 0 to 138. Bookmarks is only a kind of selection that is not visible until you use the numbers to select the text. Okay, I get the list of bookmarks, I can click on a bookmark and on a bookmark, and WP select, I take the character range and can select the content. Bookmarks are nestable, you can have a bookmark inside a bookmark. Bookmarks can, several bookmarks can contain the same text, as you know from intersection operation, for example. And bookmarks are dynamically, if the user inserts new text inside a bookmark, the text, the bookmark range is adjusted, grows or shrinks, And the last thing, a bookmark can not only contain text, as you see here, it can contain all elements that can be inside the 40Write Pro area, pictures, tables, and what else, references, and so on. Docs by templates, we are nearly done. I will show you the new way to create bookmarks, as I told you. I think I don't need my notes anymore. Before, you had for your template documents, for every document, a document on disk. For every template, a document on disk. Or for every template, or part of a template, because you can create templates, a template for header, for footer, for body part one, body part two, invoice part, or what else. For every part of a template, a record. So creating your documents was a way of searching records, loading records, opening documents from disk, copying content out of the document, copying content out of the record, pasting the content into your document. It worked, but here we have a better way. And the best thing is, or the worst thing is, before you used the clipboard to copy all using the clipboard, and then you destroyed the clipboard for your user. So you had to take care that the content in the clipboard is restored before the user tries to use his clipboard again, or he will complain. I will have all my bookmarks in one disk document or in one big record. And I search from the bookmark list which template I will need and put it into my document to create. So I simply have the initialization phase, the left 40Write Pro and the middle part we have seen before. And now, for example, I will put this regions part, this regions bookmark, into my new document. And I do it this way. I first have to create from this bookmark, which is only from character 1 to 10, a range as we talked before. Arrange as a sub-object, because I have to work and to form it and to work with sub-objects, or with ranges, excuse me. So, there I have the range. From this range I have to create a new document, because I cannot add ranges in 40Write Pro documents, I only can put documents into documents. It's different than before, but normally easy to understand. If I have created a document from this, then I go to my screen document and create also a range, because I can only insert the document into the range. This is a thing you must learn and remember and never forget. It is like 1 and 1 is 2. It is not better explainable, but it is the way it works. And if you got familiar with this, it should be easy for you. And if you created the new range, empty range, in the empty document, you can insert document, and you have transferred all the stuff over there. And you could, if you want, append a different bookmark, and code is the same. It could like this way. Or if you want to put it, to prepend it, to put it at the beginning, you press this button, and you insert this bookmark at the start of your document, before there was the constant end text 2 times. And then it is inserted on the top. And if we do such a thing, I should have done it here, we can insert the same at the cursor position. All possibilities, is possible. And the last thing, now I want to create a complete document from scratch without any template. How many minutes left?
2 minutes.
Okay. Printing in a preview, this time without suppressing the dialogues. Okay, nice with header information over there, some titles, some tables, some different pictures. Let's quit this and have a look inside. show references. Here we have a new kind of FortiWrite Pro system variables, a kind of system variables over there with fixed names. The number of the page I'm currently on and the number of pages in the document. Show values and okay, we can close this and open this and go to page 9 and open this method. And I will do it short because the way of working we have seen in the demos before, in the off-screen demos, for example. And it's always the same. It's the same way of working as you did before in old FortiWrite. You have to focus on the header or on the footer to insert text in the header or in the footer. And I do this with WP set frame page header. Then I'm in the header and insert the expressions here, the variables we spoke about. This is page 1 from 2. Then I set the frame to the footer and do the same. It's silly, but only to show you how to insert content. Then I compute in expressions once, to tell the page numbering initially start now. And we set the text. Again, working with ranges. And then some breaks for formatting, next plain text, formatting of our title line. The title line was statistics section, I think. Yes, statistics section. Range is adjusted, always adjust the range because you work with a range. And here we insert the first table, a break, next text, next table over there, with some rows in a loop. And afterwards, insert a picture with formatting. And the same for the second page and printing. Different ways of inserting pictures. So this is the way it works. And now I stop and you will have time for questions. Yes.
I see you insert table, but I didn't see a number of columns.
The table has, there are two possibilities. You can create an empty table and you say, I want to have so much columns and rows. Or you create a table as an empty table, I will say only the header. And then you can insert in a loop, the for loop, create row, create row, create row, create row, for the same table reference. It's automatically sized. If in your row are 5 values, you have 5 columns. If there are 2 values, you have 2 columns. Okay, yes, next please. Take the mic, please.
I have tried to write Pro and tables, and the tables could not jump on the next page. Is it now improved?
The table implementation is not yet ready. Okay. But it is no problem for migration, because before you never had this kind of tables. So you cannot say, I want to build my old tables into my new tables, because the old tables could not work this way. So we are working hard on adjusting what tables can, on enhancing what tables can do, but all is not possible for the moment.
It was possible to have tables in the CaddyWrite old.
Yes, I know.
With
but completely different tables.
I made a technical note about that with real tables inserting CaddyView, but it was not well known. But it was.
I know that it was not well known because it was a lot of work you have done. Other questions? Yeah. 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 Exactly.
The same holds for the objects that get, but only few, I assume.
Yeah. Yes.
So it's integration to stay in 32 bits.
Yes, so exactly.
How was the result before? So the customer said, "We had that before, but now we don't have."
So I think I can answer your questions with a wrap-up slide I have here. So very short. You have seen some new concepts, similar to the old 40-write, differently from the old 40-write. Exactly, you have to learn the new concepts, but the new concepts are based on 4D programming you know, or for 90%. And I think it is easy to migrate. Lots of well-known commands, okay. Start now. Be prepared. Don't let you force by Apple that you have to migrate exactly now. Use the time to start your migration now. If you have the problem that there is no more 32-bit version, it is a bit late for migrating. Start now, then you have time to do it. And the easy thing is, as you asked, both is working in the same 32-bit 4D now. So you have the chance for a smooth migration. You can put the first things over to the new 40-write Pro and let the old one in the old 40-write till we have all features that you need, if there should be some things missing. You should not, please don't wait with migration till all is there. Migrate now what is possible and do the rest later on, if it is possible to divide it this way, of course, yes. And yes, conversion, it runs both under 32-bit. And conversion is no one-day job. Therefore, you need certain time to migrate. So listen to my words, start now and not in 6 months.
Thank you for coming. Clap your hands.